In this video, we will look at an example that we are asked to round, and we'll show how when we're asked to round, we should use exact values to perform calculations and then round to the very end. If we round too early, we have much more of an error, which we should always try to avoid. For this problem, your car can drive 465 miles on a tank of 28 gallons of gas. Number one, how far can it drive on 41 gallons? Round the answer to the nearest mile. Number two, how many gallons are needed to drive 1,540 miles? Round the answer to the nearest tenth of a gallon. To answer these questions, we will need to express the given information as two separate rates. One way to express the rate is 465 miles per 28 gallons. We can also express the rate as 28 gallons per 465 miles. To answer the two questions, we should use these exact rates. A common error is to find the unit rates, round them, and then use the rounded rates to perform more calculations. But again, we should avoid this because it gives us more of an error. But just for review, to find the unit rate in miles per gallon, we would divide 465 by 28, which notice how if we did round to the nearest mile, this would give us a unit rate of approximately 17 miles per 1 gallon, or 17 miles per gallon. To find the unit rate in gallons per mile, we divide 28 by 465. If we did round to the nearest tenth, this would give us an approximate unit rate of 0.1 gallons per mile, or 0.1 gallons per 1 mile. Notice how because we have a 6 in the hundredths place value, we would round up to 0.1. And now let's answer the two questions. First, how far can the car drive on 41 gallons? To answer this question, we begin by writing 41 gallons as a fraction with the denominator of 1. Because we want gallons to simplify out, we use the rate with gallons in the denominator, which would be this first rate here. So again, we should use the exact rate of 465 miles per 28 gallons. So again, we multiply by 465 miles over 28 gallons. Notice how the units of gallons simplify out, leaving us with 41 times 465 divided by 28, and now the units are miles. So again, this is the correct way to answer the question because we are using the exact rate. And now going back to the calculator, we want to evaluate this quotient and then round to the nearest mile. So we have in parentheses 41 times 465 and then divided by 28. Because we have an 8 in the tenths place value, round up to 681 miles. And now let's do it the incorrect way by using the rounded unit rate of 17 miles per 1 gallon. Again, notice how the units of gallons simplify out, leaving us with 41 times 17 miles. 41 times 17 is equal to 697 miles. So this estimate is not the estimate we should use because it has much more of an error. We should use the estimate of 681 miles because we use the exact rate for the calculation. And now for number two, how many gallons are needed to drive 1,540 miles? We begin by writing this as a fraction with the denominator of 1. Because we want miles to simplify out, we use the rate with miles in the denominator, which is the second rate here. So the correct way is to use the exact rate of 28 gallons per 465 miles. Notice how the units of miles simplify out, leaving us with 1,540 times 28 divided by 465 gallons. And now we'll go back to the calculator and round this quotient to nearest tenth of a gallon. Because we have a 3 in the hundredths place value, we round down to 92.7 gallons. And now let's answer the question again and use the rounded rate of 0.1 gallons per 1 mile. This is the way we should not do it because we are going to have more of an error. Notice how the units of miles simplify out, which leaves us with 1,540 times 0.1 gallons. 1,540 times 0.1 is equal to 154. Notice how we have a big difference between the number of gallons needed to drive 1,540 miles. Our correct estimate should be approximately 92.7 gallons. It should not be 154 gallons because we use the rounded rate to perform this calculation. The estimate of 154 gallons has too much error. I hope you found this helpful.